Now let us see the what is meant by cultural evolution and biological evolution. Is there any similarities and what are the differences of biological evolution and cultural evolution? Here, biological evolution, the traits can be transmitted to a person only from the parents. So the biological evolution strongly says that whatever the traits that are there, they can be transmitted to the person only from the parents. In the cultural evolution, the cultural traits can be transmitted to a person by many unrelated people. So that is why it is called as a cultural evolution. Here, the traits can come from many unrelated species. Now next is the transmission can occur only from one generation to the next generation. The biological evolution strongly emphasizes on this point that the transmission of characters can occur only from one generation to the next generation. But in the cultural evolution, the transmission can be within or between the generations and can be widely separated with time and space. So here they say that in the cultural evolution, time and space both are playing a very important role. Now here in the biological evolution, it occurs at a slow pace. It is very, very slow pace with many generations needed to spread it right widely through a population. But in the cultural evolution, it occurs at a fast pace with it may involve immediate learning and does not require any inheritance. So here they emphasize on the physiology and also phylogeny of learning. Learning is playing an important role for the cultural evolution. So here, if you see here in the biological evolution, the traits acquired in a lifetime cannot be transmitted via genetic inheritance. They cannot be transmitted via genetic inheritance. But in cultural evolution, the cultural traits can be transmitted within a lifetime via teaching or imitation. So by imitating or by taking the what are the teaching methods and all, also the evolution has come into existence. Like that, the cultural evolution is giving the postulations. Now here, the people cannot choose which genetic traits they will inherit. Is it not? In biological evolution, the people cannot take, I want this character, I want that character, I want to be fair, I want to be tall or I want to be short. So the people have no choice to take the traits. Whereas in the cultural evolution, people can choose to accept or to reject some cultural traits. So they have that aspects of accepting or cancelling the different traits. Now here the data is transmitted which is encoded by the genetic material. So in the biological evolution, DNA is playing a vital role. That means whatever the data that is there, it is encoded and also transmitted from one generation to another generation only by this particular genetic material. But whereas in the cultural evolution, the data transmitted can assume in the form of written or spoken languages. So everything here, that has to be taken only in the written formats. So here it is the genetic encoding, here it is the written format. So this is the another important aspect of cultural evolution, and the very basis for biological evolution is only the genetic material, which is playing a very vital role for encoding or the traits, or the next generation has got no other choice only to take up whatever that is make up in their genetic material.